sibling issues, but God forbid I should even reference the boundary thing, even though I actually know what I'm talking about.
By the way, I am not in crisis. I haven't been in crisis in a year.
You just got out of rehab.
Oh, God. Why is this so difficult for you to understand? Rehabilitation, crisis. You should really learn the difference.
For you editors out there, what I would do is I do, you know, first go through and take the pieces that I think I might want to use and make a sequence out of those. I call that my pull sequence. And then I'll, you know, make a copy of that, pare that down to version one, and then I edit version one onto the tail of my pull sequence. And if you have dupe detection turned on, you can see exactly what I can see exactly what I've used and what I haven't used. And so as I go through version two, I try not to use anything I've already used. Or certainly if I'm going to use it, cut in and out of it differently. Just to force myself to try something different, because this footage, it's very hard to, you know what to do.
I just want to load the dish.
There's a couple doozies coming up here. So, time cut there. Another time cut here.
You know, I hope it was okay that.
But now watch this one. Look at everyone's position.
Dinner about the baby.
Of course it was lamb chop. You should tell. I'm just so happy because I'm going to be a grandbaby.
And then watch this. Look at this cut here. How'd she get over there? She was over there. You know, in this case, I'm not doing that on purpose. I'm not doing that to be clever and, ooh, watch me flip everybody around. It was because this one take here, there's just a real genuine moment from Bill Irwin's performance here that we liked. There's another couple of shots where, you know, there's these two other people, two friends in the room who don't say a word. They're just standing there, the blonde woman and the guy eating the watermelon. Their job was just to be there and be in the scene. And because of the way the film was shot, they knew that they had a serious job to do, which was be there and be in character and just react to whatever happens. Got some great stuff from
them. Like this, Rach, you can't. It's a total setup. It's not fair.
Yeah.
I love that shot. That's one of my favorite things in the scene. And you wouldn't normally get that. In a normal scene, shot with normal actors, in the normal way, you know, he didn't know. He was just there acting, and the camera went over and got him. You know, when I think back to this film, it's actually pretty heavy, but I always think of it as a comedy because we had so much fun making it. The process was so enjoyable. And, you know, with this kind of footage, it's just scene after scene where this real kind of loose way of cutting, which was forced on me by the footage. It's not like I had some normal footage and decided to cut it. Ooh, wouldn't it be cool if I cut all kinds of crazy ways? If you do that, you'll have a mess. You have to look at the footage and let the footage tell you what the best way to cut it is.